fail.
Are you listening?
Okay, I think we are on now.
Damn.
Hi guys, welcome to Chronicles of the Dead, powered by Next Week. I am Nancy, and with me I have
Official Ames, and we also have a special guest in the house, Bolajii.
Hi.
So how are you today, Bolajii?
I'm good.
So we would like to get to know more about you, what you do. So we know you currently as someone who like with some music, but would like to know like what you do and basically just tell us what you do.
What are you using that information for? So I'm Bolajii, bad boy Bolajii, and basically I'm an artist. And
you don't sing.
I do see. So I'm an artist and I'm also a software engineer.
I see. How does that work for you? Like, you being an artist and seeing better software engineer, how do you see manage it too?
Well, I wouldn't say it's something that I'll have to manage, because like you could say you're managing like two things if they are two different things. I don't know how I'm going to explain it, but like music is something that I just do. I do it at like my leisure time when I'm not doing anything. While software engineering is work I actually have to do. So
what, like, what led you to start music? Like, what inspired you to dive into music? Because the biology I knew was a tempo. So what's up? What's in being soft?
Plenty tells myself. The thing is, I actually wrote like music like a few years ago, you understand, but that didn't come out well. Like the music didn't end up well, and I played for some of my guys and they run away from my own chef.
Wow.
I remember that.
So that's like emphasis on how bad it was.
Okay.
You understand, but I didn't like let it just die there. You understand? I think what it would like reviving the whole thing, there was a day, my guy, Nax.
Yeah.
N-E-X. Oh. Yeah. So he did this mad freestyle and he posted it on Instagram.
Okay. Oh.
And I think you know what I'm talking about. And when I was like, oh, Nax did this, why can't I? You understand?
Nax inspired you to
do something like that.
Nax, I hope you can hear this.
And I was like, if Nax can do this, why can't I? Then I wrote something by 1 a.m. I was in Nax DS. I was like, you bro, check the shells. And he listened to it. He gave me some mistakes, sure. Okay. You understand? Which was normal. Like, to be long since I wrote music. Yeah, so he gave me some corrections. I worked on it. We wrote more music. As I then, we were still rapping. You understand? So we wrote more music. Trapping, no rapping. Okay. You understand? But that was when I now dropped like Bad Boy and stuff. So okay. But that's like far deeper into the story. But basically that's
okay. So you're a student at UNN, you're in Lyon technically.
Yes.
So I also know you were a software developer and you're in your second year now.
I am a software developer.
And so you are, sorry, you're still a software. Yeah. So how are you able to balance school and work? Like, did you give one up for the other one? Or how did you mix the two?
Well, I'm a very simple person. Okay. You understand? And I honestly just go with what works for me. I pick my priority.
Which is?
I mean, priorities are subjective, but to me, like, because I feel technically I'm in computer science, I'm a student of computer science, and the end role is to get a job.
Okay.
But if I already have that job, the same job I'm supposed to be getting, you understand? There was a time I did an interview and they were like, do you have a degree? And I was like, nope. They were like, yeah, no problem. That they just wanted to know if I had a degree or not, that it's not a problem. You understand? Because I feel programming is more about what you know here than the degree or something like that. Exactly.
They still put the degree as something that matters, actually.
Exactly. Those are them. You understand? For me, I believe that, I've always believed that my life has started.
Okay. Okay.
You understand? So why should I wait for 4 years of my life before I enter into
it? So what you're saying in essence is that you've prioritized your software engineering career.
I prioritize my source of income to
school.
I see. That's nice, actually. So what stack, what kind of developer are you?
I'm actually a full stack engineer. I'm a JavaScript software engineer.
I don't know what that is, Vulcan.
So I'm a JavaScript software engineer. I build front-end applications and back-end applications, you understand, and a little bit of mobile, React Native.
I see you perform at Bolajii Carnival. How was that for you?
That was amazing for me.
Crazy. Are there other places you actually performed at in the year and year?
First thing, UNN doesn't rate its talents.
That's sad.
UNN doesn't rate its talents. So I think I'm going to make a reference back to last year. Was it last year? When did we have this show?
That was last year.
Yeah, the SCG Bonfire. So I wanted to perform. You understand? That was around the time I dropped Bad Boy. You understand? So I wanted to perform, but they don't grade me.
It happens. You don't always get what you want.
Exactly. And because honestly, like, I really wanted to perform because when I got there, I saw the turn up, I saw the amount of people were present, and it was mad. Crazy. And I was like, oh, well, people will reach a few, like 500 or 1K.
Actually,
you understand? Exactly. And I was like, oh, well, I have to perform here, you understand? And at least it's something for Bolajii, like the bad
man. For me, the bonfire was very bad day for me because I left on time, so
it was a bad day for you.
I swear.
Oh, well, was that like 3 a.m.? I was having trouble.
What did you say?
I said I was having trouble with like the smell man, so I left. Like, I couldn't
eat. Come on.
I was there now.
I didn't do that till like 5 a.m. I am big on events. I'll do dance. I can't believe it. I'll be there till the end.
So, we'll dance, like, meeting new people, have fun. That's what the events are all about for me. Like, bullies, people have fun and dress. I don't know about other people, but for me, that's what events are all about. So, I know there are upcoming shows, and we hope to see more of your work. We hope to see more of your music. We hope to see more of you out there. Because currently, I don't know much artists in UNN, except you and J Brown and a few other guys. So, so seeing you out there is something I want to see like more often. And I'm very sure a lot of people want to see you out there more often. So,
speaking of being out there more often, you were like out there like 2 weeks ago, like for a week, you were trending. So, me, I want to ask you now.
That's true.
I want to ask you now that we have him here. You said you had. No, let's start from the body, please. Let's start from the genesis. Let's not jump into the mix. So, you said something about body preferences that hits people. I want you to repeat it. So that one I'm not here, not time to hear it now.
Hear what he said. Repeat this, please. Spot boy. Okay, so I posted on my Instagram story. You understand? I posted on my Instagram story that I prefer girls that do not have OBP. You understand?
Yeah.
That was what I said.
Not what he said.
That was that old
day. Okay, yeah. Calm the fuck down, girls. Okay. Yeah, then I also said that I would rather have senior wood than have a girl with a beach to walk.
That's crazy. Senior is like the con master, as you all know. Like, why would you compare like people out there since?
But then that's not even what I wanted to say. I remember BBC what Bolajii said because I studied in my brain for things like this. So you want? I think your first paragraph was like as a babe. So yes. I feel like that was weird. Most babes had problems. Like, as a babe, why should you have... That was what you said. Right or wrong?
Correct.
So, are you still standing that your first... Are you standing with the fact that your first... the opening part of that your statement, was it right? Do you feel like it was the right thing to say?
Well, I prefer not to. First off, repeat. I wasn't generalizing it though.
As a babe.
Calm down, wait.
So you were looking so unspecific.
Why are you guys bringing words out of my mouth?
But
why are you guys bringing words out of my mouth?
Apologize.
So, honestly, I was actually referring to somebody.
To dog.
But trust me, you guys don't know the person.
Okay.
And the person that retaliated to my post is not even the person.
Okay.
You understand?
Okay.
So, like, it was just a bad experience I had, and I decided to, like, share my story on Instagram.
But do you feel like that was, like, the right way to convey what you were feeling at that time?
I conveyed what I was feeling.
But you still stand with what you said being correct. Like,
yes.
Although people dragged you, like, smart no, and gadget.
I don't care.
You don't
care. Do you know, like, that morning, you know that morning, like, because if you check, I posted that thing around 1 a.m., 2 a.m.
Okay.
By 9 in the morning, my manager calling my phone.
Kudo. Steady calling smartphone.
Yeah, because, like, my phone was on sleep focus, you understand? So, next thing, I pulled down my notification bar. I saw him calls. I called him back. The next thing, he was like, Bolajii, what have you done?
Yeah.
Bolajii, what have you done? You said the UN is on fire. I was like, oh, moral. Wait till I zoom. It was like, what did, because at that point, I didn't even remember that I even posted something on Instagram. Well, you understand? I just.
But what do you feel like? What do you feel about the reception that particular post got? And what do you feel about people reacting to your own preference?
Well, I feel like anybody that reacted that way was dumb.
Anybody that reacted how?
Yes.
That said how?
That, like, basically telling me, because women broke shame guys. Women talk shit about guys.
I agree.
Women will tell a guy that he's fat and he will hit the gym. So when I say the same thing, why is he a problem?
Okay.
You
so
understand?
You feel like anybody that reacted in a negative way to your post is dumb, in your words, right?
I'm not trying to stay up. I don't
know. I'm not trying to stay up.
I'm not trying to stay up or my another issue or okay. Bring more heat out. That's how I like my
life. The girl in question, the girl that, like, has an Apache on her TikTok. I was trying to see the video. Like, she Apache on her TikTok.
Okay, past tense.
Recent.
Yeah, that has stopped.
No, it has not. She did more recent video again. I saw some recent DMs, and I'm like,
well, she blocked me on serious. She blocked me on all social media platforms. So,
and it's the fact that I mean, blocking, I know.
Why block me? Why block me and talk shit about me?
Okay.
If you don't talk shit about me, at least I should hear it.
What
so bring it to my face. Are you so scared? I don't care.
No, I just maybe you know people react to things differently. So maybe that's how she's reacting to what you said. Because I know,
like, do you know? I don't actually give a fuck about how she reacted to the whole thing.
Okay.
Because first off, I was in no way we're cool.
Okay.
You understand?
I swear,
we're actually friends. You understand? And when I saw the whole thing happen, I was like. When I posted the whole thing, she entered my DM. I was like, why are you? She said, if I know her anything, all this, I would be hiding my face. Then I told her that if you're coming to my DM to drop hate speech, just go to the comment section and do the same as others are doing. Then she was like, no, she's coming to my DM as my friend. You understand? And blah, blah, blah. I was like, oh, this is your talking, because I mean, my mom be saying, don't yab me or don't say anything in my DM. You understand? Then she went on to say that she believes that, in her own words, I think she said that she shouldn't be related. People she call her friends are intelligent.
Intelligent.
She doesn't look or seem intelligent at all. She's not intelligent.
Okay, that's why he knew what she's in.
Okay, this sounds like a beef between me and whoever we're talking about. It's fine. It's fine.
I was on my own. I was like, at the sideline.
Okay.
Blinds do referee where they actually like bring the fight out to the streets. And then the next
time is actually not helpful.
And I'm like, why?
Okay, so
I wasn't supportive of what he said. One, I'm going to be back with him. I wasn't supportive of what he said. Why?
Dodo.
I was like, they better always swear your opinion now. Like, make it
so. What should I have said?
No, see, that's the thing. I feel like I don't want to be very subjective in this. I'm trying to be as objective as possible. I feel like most people's problem was with the first paragraph as a babe. I feel like if you had scrapped the as a babe, I have preferences. Like, I cannot say as a guy, why haven't you been to jail? Because maybe I'm attracted to thugs.
But then the advice she gave you was
Well, then if you're not sad, maybe I can't date a babe with big Ben. Or a woman says, I can't date a broke guy. It will be different. But you said as a babe. So I think it was
when you say as a guy, most of the
time. Me, I'm not seen as a guy, but maybe when I see.
Are you for real?
Yeah, I'm not saying.
So I'm not seen as a guy. I've seen all these things trying to keep the girl away. As a guy, why would we be doing this? As a guy, why?
I've seen something that.
Okay, this is where I end my own case.
Exactly. So.
I bow my head.
Stop. See, I just feel. See, the one thing is that most of the time women get to me with a lot of stuff.
Is this a gender war now?
It's not a gender war.
Okay.
You understand?
So that time of the month for her, actually.
I don't give a fuck about what time we're going to choose from her, guy. Do you understand? So.
Anyways, moving forward. So.
The next question is, what's your preference when it comes to.
What's your spec? So if I want to shoot my shots in your DM, who should I be? What should I have?
I like my girls. Slim and pretty.
It's a sad thing that.
Sorry, actually.
So, slim, pretty,
Ebony.
Ebony. Kini Ebony.
I don't know what's in there.
Ebony is dark skinned, right? I feel I look so dumb now. I knew about. Okay, I'm fair, so I cannot. He's fine. I chopped myself. This fine, this fine, this fine.
Yeah, interesting.
Okay, so that's your spec. Nothing with intellectuals. As far as you are fine, slim, pretty.
That's,
I don't have fine
options. I don't see there's a difference between when I say my spec, it's someone I'm attracted to.
Okay.
Yes, you understand. Mm-hmm. Then if I'm talking to you and I see that you're not intellectually upright.
So your spec includes you being intellectually upright?
Yes, obviously, you understand. But I mean, at the first glance, if I.
Plus, it's not a prerequisite for you to fall. Like, must the person be intelligent?
Good. I'm seeing what you guys are trying to do him all the way.
I don't they ask questions.
It's just questions. No, you don't. Obviously, she won't be dumb.
Okay.
You understand? Well, I'm not looking for like Einstein or something.
Okay.
A woman.
Well, just kind of.
Exactly.
Noted. So, you just want us to get dark skinned. No one. We can run it. I mean, also got someone hands up.
That beforehand, there was no one who had people like issues with said Delphi and. Like you would think I should cool up towards the point you made that post.
I'm still cool, yeah. I don't know.
You're still cool with her.
Like, I don't. Honestly, while I've already carried social media for like.
Hypnology, yeah. How was it feel like when you go on and then you see her? How do you react? How will she react? What's in her reaction?
The way you see reaction, like, I saw the other hand, I'm like,
Like, my dad, I'll go down.
Do you guys say like,
Richard,
how has this been? The aftermath of the whole internet drama, how has it been being in the same lodge? And so of you, are you guys the next door neighbors?
What
like, actually, so how has it been? Has anybody put calabash in front of your house?
Oh, bro, honestly. Well, honestly, I'm actually going to see this, and it's actually funny, but I mean, we can do anything. So I was extra secure about my room, you understand? Before the person go knock, I opened the door and pour me a sip. You understand? Because I know that women could actually. I'm not saying women, human beings are unstable.
Thank you.
Yes. human beings are very unstable.
Yes.
You understand? But aside that, like, I think what she was doing, like, after, I think for like a week after I posted that song with this I dropped for her, she was always playing it. And I feel maybe she was trying to tell me that it doesn't affect her, but I don't really care. I did my share. I dropped my work off out and I'm out. You understand?
Amen. So everything has been chill. The after.
I haven't seen Asha. I
we've been a busy man.
Like always.
In it.
Yeah, awesome.
So you play FIFA yet?
Yeah.
Yeah. Aside playing FIFA and needing what else?
What'd you say?
Aside playing FIFA and you didn't just like, you mean what else?
Did I tell you I play?
Because you're a bad boy, like, your signature.
What did I tell you?
And then they get cut out, like, or probably with someone, where it'll be. Just, like, imagine how other girls would react and everything. So it's obvious you have, like, so you want a little bit there, but you'll be supporting, or, like.
I have supporters.
You'll see, and beams. So I'll buy your superpowers, but most of your superpowers.
I feel very uncomfortable. being this conversation about women.
Well, I'm answering the streets all personally, like aside Gifan, Human Lopez, and non.
What else do you do?
Is the emphasis?
I feel like you've done. Ha! You know, when this guy bossed the next. You
do
you work? Do you one X bet? I mean, which one do you think?
Use my promo code.
Crazy one. So we like you have the promo code.
No, I don't.
Guy, do you play with us for yeah? Do we look like we're playing?
I was asking my producer festival.
If I was like, everybody has a rig.
I do not.
I mean, you know,
there'll be people in. You actually make professional questions.
But yeah,
what would be burning
you?
I don't. Bombastic side eye.
Really? So I also ask this question. Do you wish your ex well?
My ex?
Yes, you wish her well.
Is it just one ex you have?
Like all your exes, like you wish they well?
Yes.
Wait, how many exes do you have?
I don't know, but
how many exes do you have?
You also, you can use your fingers to punch your own.
I don't give you mine.
No, it's like, I don't say anything that was I don't say anything that would seem false.
Okay, this is very, very... We've not said, like, let's say, yeah, actually.
I wish all my exes...
You go to find with how many... You wish them with you, I said, but how many exes you have?
We need, like... Do you mean, like, from now to, like, last year?
No, from...
Your entire lifetime.
When you said, like...
My entire lifetime.
Your butt.
Lifetime.
I would say, like, 4 or 5.
Oh, that's green. So there's this other question I have, like the very sweet but like, I have sweet questions, but actually, so like if you cheat on your baby, okay, and then
I don't support cheating.
What does she be?
It's clear.
If you have comments, and then your baby decides to be cool about it and says they can back new system in our relationship.
If I cheat,
yes.
No, I won't cheat too.
You won't cheat.
I'm a very loyal man.
Crazy.
In that
small bombastic side eye.
I think that I am bad boy.
Okay, no, see, let me. I think you're misunderstanding the whole bad boy thing. The whole bad boy thing is there. I feel I'm incapable of love. Do you understand? And I don't want to put somebody in the situation where it's not be like, I see, like, you don't touch me. Do you understand? So,
really,
and besides, if I'm, let's say, if I'm talking to you now, you understand, and she probably feels that I would do everything that it's for her.
Yes.
I should say I like it tomorrow. But that's the thing. The thing now is that I'm not on the other person because I'm not attached to you.
Okay.
It's not as if I asked you out and I'm going after someone else.
Okay.
So that's it.
But we're talking about your babe here, Miss Unbex.
Oh, my babe.
Yes. Yeah. Like you cheat on her too. Like you can't say you're not after your babe. Obviously, she's your babe, then obviously we're after and you're butting up.
Okay, so if I cheat on my babe and she's cool with it, first of all, if my babe cheats on me, I would not be cool with it. If she's cool with it, I'll be surprised and I'll leave because, I mean, why would she be cool with it?
And crazy.
Yeah, people do things.
Word.
It might seem ungood. Give it 2 years, man. Your head is.
But then, okay, so you've been talking about, babe, these four exes, they are for your lifetime, right?
Yeah.
Like since you were in baby till now. So how many of them are in this school, for example?
None.
No, so you've not had any.
One.
Ha!
Well,
where are you? You did that in this school. How was it?
It was nice. Well, she did give me an ultimatum. See, if I don't ask her out by the end of the moon, she could move on.
Wait. I don't understand. I am very confused.
So, 100 level shit.
So, you counted 5 exes. You said 5 exes. One of them is in the school. And then the ultimatum she gave you is that if you do not ask her out, do you ask someone you're already in a relationship with out?
No. Like I was saying that she, well, before we did it now, she was giving me an ultimatum and so stuff like that, yeah.
But then you guys said for how long? A year?
No, it was very short.
2 weeks.
I think like a month or 3 weeks.
Give grace. How's it going?
Hallelujah.
So are you looking forward to falling in love this year?
No.
Next year?
No.
2 years?
No.
Yeah. That's very sad.
Did you even get married?
I'm not sure.
Good also.
Yeah. Life's tough.
Crazy.
Anyways, Okay, I don't have anything to say again.
I would accept my reasons, but I don't want to trigger anybody.
You will not train for like another 3 weeks.
Go ahead, Ajim. Nah, I'm good. I'm good.
Back in Costa Rica.
I feel like I'm actually understand and people them actually understand. So how would they know what he wants to see if you haven't said it, and then think they will judge you but because of what you said or he wants to see?
That's what I told you last time.
They could just tell us your reason. Why do you feel like in the next couple of years, or you're not going to get married?
I think I started with that now, the whole being incapable of love shit. Because, like, it's not really, really incapable of love. Just that I can, I know how to show love, but I just don't know when I need to meet too many women at
the time. Like you say, no one has posted that this, like, you've been in UNN.
One person has actually, but they end up high on the dating.
I am. Must be sad.
Nah.
Oh, you feel sad?
Fuck.
It's like, I want. That's life happening now.
I mean, you don't always get what you want.
Exactly.
I mean. So, should we be, since we are not expecting love from you this year or next year, should we be expecting music projects, shows? Like, what should we expect from the Bad Boy brand?
Well, for shows. Bro, if it's like a personal show, no, bro. If it's like from other shows, yeah. I think there are some upcoming shows I'm slotted in for already this year. Then as for music projects, I have a little bit cooking actually.
We cooking?
You understand?
Chefs and chefs.
Yeah, coming in hot.
That's great.
So that's it, pretty much it.
Okay, so I guess that's all. But do you still have any other questions on to ask?
Questions on my end. I feel like I've busted the guy enough.
Okay, so
what is each?
Sensation.
Them guys thought they do the same.
Crazy.
You say not sensational. They are a future indeed. But anyways, I think that's all. So
yeah.
She's anyone that will listen to every day, you say.
Oh, Hank doesn't get it. It's not like our kinky inside joke. It's fine. No. I don't know that I've got this. Oh yeah, Bele. But you don't know sensational, don't you? You know who?
Obviously, it's feature.
Okay, now because I thought, fuck. Wait, it's fine. We're not entering you.
Sensational.
To the woman. Say it again.
Sensational.
To the
woman. Is there anything you would like to tell the audience?
Okay, yeah, I think I have three things. So, number one, stream Bad Boy. Number two, stream Bad Boy. Don't forget. And number three, sensational.
Wow, what an outro for him, my dude.
That's
so guys, we've come to the end of another episode of the Chronicles of the Den, and wallahi, it was an awesome episode with our Bad Boy Bolajii. I should be doing like all this vocal for these guys because I so good wallahi. So anyways, stay tuned for more episodes. I mean, we're supposed to be doing this weekly. And for you to be informed on when we're dropping our next episode, you should follow our socials. I mean, we're at Chronicles of the Den on every social media platform. So you should check us out. And this video was produced by Next Wave. So you should check them out on YouTube. And turn on your post notifications. And there's one bonus design I'm trying to remember. Okay, you snooze, you lose. So don't snooze on us.